Get a whole lot of fun out of every gallon with the highly efficient Fiat 500X. And right now at your local Fiat dealer, get $4,500 total cash allowance on the 2017 Fiat 500X Lounge. It's made to get the good times rolling with an EPA estimated 30 highway MPG and ready to keep them going with a Beats Audio premium sound system. Visit FiatUSA.com and your local Fiat dealer for great offers on the Fiat 500X. Available feature, residency restrictions apply. Take retail delivery from dealer stock by 1/2/18.
Blog Talk Radio.
Everybody get up.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was Blurred Lines by Robin Thicke. This is Off the Chain. I am your host, Jim Mason. This is the last show of 2017. Can y'all believe that? Tomorrow night is New Year's Eve here in the United States, and it is our absolute last show for the year. Not the last show for us, but the last show for the year. The next show will be in 2018. And I want to say that it has been a ride and a half. Little did I realize when I started this show almost 2 years ago that we would have so much success and that it would take on its own life form. And I have to thank all of you, the audience, the listeners, the guests, everyone that has tuned into this show, whether the live show, the archives, one of the dozen podcasts this thing is heard on. I am just so grateful, so humble, so amazed, and so appreciative that this show is giving artists and people with platforms and musicians and authors and people that wouldn't have otherwise a voice in over 100 countries. That being said, on Blog Talk Radio, Australia is our biggest listening base. And I want to say thank you for that. Because of y'all, countries that listen on Blog Talk Radio, we have reached 85,683 listeners as of today. Now, just take a moment to soak in that number, 85,683 listeners. And because Australia is such a large listening base, I have to promote some of their hometown boys, the Teskey Brothers. They're a blues band that sound like they should be on the Bourbon Street during Mardi Gras and not in Down Under, because they sound like some of the USA's homegrown boys, Robert Johnson, Eric Clapton, Johnny Lang, B.B. King, Otis Redding. You know all those boys that have to have. Brothers, if you haven't had an opportunity to listen to them, go and find them. They're on all of the music venues, Reverbination, CD Baby, iTunes, and look them up on Facebook, because they are an amazing group of young men. When you add the podcast that this show is heard on, which is iTunes and YouTube and FM.com, TuneIn Radio, SoundCloud, MixCloud, Spreaker, Podcast, and Podcast Garden, and that's just the ones that I know about. And Stitcher. There are other podcasts this show comes up on that I don't put it on. Someone else does. But when you add all those podcasts together with the show, we have reached 106,580 listeners. Again, that number is just almost overwhelming. It's almost unfathomable. 106,583 listeners in over 100 countries, ladies and gentlemen. So the people that come on the show are in places like Tanzania and Brazil and Italy and Greece and Ireland and Wales and England and South Africa and New Zealand, Russia even, places that you wouldn't think that we would be heard, but we're heard. We're even heard in Iran, if you can believe that one. So I want to say thank you. And if you want to come on the show, contact me at offthechainradio@yahoo.com. If you would much rather advertise on the show, feel free. Go to advertisecast.com and look up Off the Chain. My rates are reasonable. I mean, they should be criminal. They're so reasonable. And I will advertise your show for 1 month from the day I get the ad, 30 days later. I will advertise that show for 30 days. Whether I have 4 shows, 5 shows, 6 shows, however many shows I have in that week or in that month, that your ad will be on every single show. And with that being said, I want to say thank you to Miss Cece Chamberlain, who placed an ad with me. And I am advertising her ad tonight. She has a podcast called Inside Your Life with Cece. It's on www.podcast.com. And she can be heard on iTunes and Google Play. And what Cece says about her podcast, Inside Your Life with Cece, is it's a podcast full of thought-provoking interviews, which are motivational and inspirational, to inspire others and to lift up their souls with feel-good stories, conversations to strengthen the mind, the body, and the soul. And for us, inspiration and motivation sometimes is few and far between. However, with Inside Your Soul with Cece, you will find the glimmer of hope in a world full of confusion, which is discouraging at times. And sometimes it's just tough days, ladies and gentlemen. Sometimes it's just really tough days to get through, especially if you've had a trauma in your life, whether it's illness or death or separation. Go and listen to her podcast, because her interviews will not only entertain you, they uplift you, and they bring the absolute best out of the world. There's plenty of good in the world. Cece will bring that on her podcast, Inside Your Life with Cece, at www.podcast.com/Inside Your Life with Cece. So check it out. And put this on your calendars, ladies and gentlemen. On Friday, January the 5th, at 9 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Now, if you're in a different time zone, you're going to have to account for whatever time zone you're in. But if you're in Eastern Standard Time at 9 o'clock on the Investigation Discovery Channel, there's a show that is called Married with Secrets. I will be on that show on January the 5th at 9 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. I will be discussing Gerard Schaefer, who was Florida's first serial killer, who was a Martin County deputy, which is the next county south of me. And not even his sheriff knew what he was doing. His wife didn't know. This man killed between 9 and 35 young women between 1966 and 1972. And we will be discussing three of those murders on the show, Married with Secrets. And if you have not yet read the book, Silent Scream, by your host, Terry Von Mason, go to Amazon and download it. You can also get the print copy. You can also get it at Barnes & Noble. It's also available on Nook. And read the book before you watch the show, because there is so much more in the book that we could not get in an hour show. It was a 4.5-hour interview for an hour show, which is really 30 minutes by the time you add all the commercials. So go and get that book, Silent Scream, by Von Mason, and read it before January the 5th at 9 o'clock when I will be on Married with Secrets on the Investigation Discovery Channel. So with all the housekeeping out of the way, I want to welcome back a young man that helped me out the other night, and I'm so grateful for him and Robert Thompson. They stepped right up. We had an open mic night, and it was an interesting and fulfilling and informative and educational night, and I am very, very grateful for them for doing that. And the other half of the Robert Thompson and myself was graphic designer James Karlson. He is a Phoenix native who now lives in California with his wife and four children. He is a freelance graphic designer and publisher for indie authors. His freelance service is called Graphic, and he's offered his help to authors that need more distributorship across the globe instead of just Amazon since 2005. That's how long he's been in business. Teamed up with his marketing director and his editor, James' insight on online publishing and its unprofessionalism will amaze you. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, there is unprofessionalism in our business. Sad to say, but it does happen. So with that being said, James, I want to welcome you back to the show, and thank you.
Thank you for having me, Yvonne. It's good to see you again.
It was an interesting night that night. I mean, that hour flew by faster than most of them, and they all fly by, but that one just 5 minutes and it was gone.
I was so amazed by the end of the show. I was like, wow, that was just amazing, you know. So, yeah, it was really good.
So let's talk about James in the business. Let's talk about James for just a minute. Did you have any idea that this was where your professional life was going to take you growing up?
Well, it started back in 2002. I wanted to be a writer, and I had the big dreams of making big money and signing autographs, and we all do it. And if you haven't, you're lying. And, you know, I had to be honest with myself because, you know, it's really hard. You know, I've gotten rejection letters for one of my novels called Black Petals. It was blurbed by the great Piers Anthony. This actual book, believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, this actual book that I was writing was critiqued by Stephanie Meyer of Twilight before she became famous. I believe she was at BYU at the time, but she was in one of the workshops, the writing workshop, where you could go in and have your stuff critiqued. And Stephanie Meyer had talked to me about writing, and she had talked to me about her books. And at the time, I was working at Walmart, and she sent me an email, and she said, "My books are out. I got published at the writer's house in New York. Look for it." Now, here I am. There's like 25 big boxes of Stephanie Meyer Twilight books. And I'm like, wow, this is amazing. And this is what I wanted to do. But, you know, it is so hard to get in that business. It really is. Tonight I'm going to be talking about the unprofessionalism in the business. I'm going to be talking about why it is important to have a designer on your side instead of paying thousands and thousands of dollars to vanity publishers that claim that they're traditional. So we're definitely taking calls tonight. You can call me at 516-387-1756. The number again is 516-387-1756. If you want to ask me questions on my messengers, you can find me on Facebook. Search Jane Karlson, K-A-R-L-S-O-N, and you can jot your question down on Messenger. I will answer your question definitely on the show. When you look for my name, you'll see the name graphic right underneath. That's me. So let's get the ball rolling and let's have some fun.
All right, then. Okay, first thing first. You and I both understand the importance of a book cover that pops, and it has to grab the eye. It's has to be not only appealing, but it has to make the buyer, without even thinking about it, reach out and pick that book up, whether it's the genre they read or not. Curiosity from the cover. It's an automatic reflex to reach out and pick up that book. In our business, how many bad book covers have you seen?
How many of the what?
Bad book covers have you seen in our business?
Oh, I I have seen so many, and I'm sure you've probably done this, Yvonne, where you picked up a book cover or book and looked at the cover, and you're like, my Lord, I could have done better than this. This is just ridiculous. And to think that New York even came up with this, or even the self-publishing places that I won't bash any companies. I think we know who we're talking about. But the covers are so ridiculous. And even the ones that are slapped, you know, even the ones that just have a picture on it, and they think it's a cover design. That's not a cover design. My five-year-old could have done that, okay? So the cover is very important. It's got to grab the eye, and it's got to be able to make that person go over there and go, wow, what is this book about?
And would you agree, James, the cover should give an idea of what's between the front and the back cover? The cover should say something about what the story is about, even if it's just a hint.
That is definitely true. And I try to abide by that. One of my clients, and you probably, you've had him on your show a couple of times. His name is David Elcroft. He's one of my clients. And David is all about grabbing his stories in motion picture effect, placing it on the cover. And he's really good about trying to turn his book into some kind of cinema scene to grab the readers and, you know, and let them know, hey, it's okay, come over and have a read, you know. And not just the book cover, but the inside is really, really OCD about the inside. It's the readability, the flow, the how it looks. The pages have to basically invite you in to read the book. And David is so good about that, and not once has he ever corrected me. Well, in the beginning he did, and I was just starting out. But right now, he just basically says, here's my book, run with it, and let me know when you're done.
And you were right. The inside, you pick up this, and it, and you open it up, and it flow. It's like opening up a package that's packaged, but on the inside.
I call it the Pandora's box, because you don't know what you're going to expect. You don't know what's going to come out. You know, I had one author told it's like a box. You don't know what you're going to get, you know. And it's true. It's true. You don't know what you're going to get. And once you do get in that book and you like it, you're no longer looking for titles. You're now looking for the brand, which is the author. And that is what, that's what gets you every time. You go into a bookstore, and I'll look for a book, and I'll look at the covers first. I'll be honest. I'll look at the covers, and I'm like, oh, that looks interesting, and I'll take a look. And, you know, and that's how I got hooked on to Jane Patterson. That's how I got hooked on to, you know, E.L. James. You know, I see the covers, and I read the book, and then now I'm hooked on to Jane Patterson. Jane Patterson is my all-time favorite. And I can't go in a bookstore and not look at what, you know, just to see what he put out, or if I want to spend, you know, $29 for a hardcover of his or whatever. It, you know, I'm always investigating Jane Patterson, and that's how it starts. Once you get a fan base that loves you, they're not going to be looking for covers anymore. They're going to be looking for you.
Because as I've been showing, you've heard me preach, what we sell brand, it's the product of our brand. We are the brand. And once people recognize us and our name, what's a product does anymore, because they know that the ad is worth their time. But you still want that pop-in cover. You still want... I always tell people that I talk to, you have one or two choices. You can either run with the herd, or you can run ahead of the herd, because if you run with the herd, you'll never be seen.
Yeah. And a lot of times, authors will be so distracted. See, this is the thing that really, now we're going to go off the chain here. This is what really gets me about authors, that when I look at self-published books, and when I look at traditional publishing as well, you know, like Jane Patterson and Harlan Coben, even my best friend Natasha Preston. Hi, Natasha. I know you're on the line. I see you. And I also know for sure that, you know, sometimes you can't tell the difference between a self-published book and sometimes, and that's good. Your book should not be screaming self-publishing. It should not be. There's no doubt in your mind that, you know, that is a traditional book. That's what your book should be saying. But a lot of authors, they put out books and they don't have a clue what they need to do to make their book succeed, to make it look good, to make it commercial. And that's why, ladies and gentlemen, that's why I think it's very important that you have a graphic designer under your belt to help you with that publishing, to get that book cover, to get the lettering and the kernels right, get the colors right. The graphic designer knows that stuff. You don't. You just wrote the book. The designer will help you.
On that same note, James, it's not just the graphics. It's the font. It's the the color of the title and the author's name and the position that it's placed. And
exactly.
Go ahead.
Go ahead. You go first.
Okay. What I was going to say is after a time, the title becomes a smaller font because the author's name becomes larger because that's what people associate. They could just have the title, like you said, just a new book by the author, and they're ready to read because they're hooked on the author.
You're right, okay? But at the same time, for instance, when I have a client, okay, my concern is with branding the author, okay, not the book. I know I'm going to do the book. I know I'm going to design the book, but the book is not my problem, okay? And I'm gonna expand with that so you understand why I'm saying that. And people are probably going choking on something right now. What, he's a graphic designer and he's getting paid to do a book and the book is not his concern? Let me explain that. My instruction comes from who? The client. And the client will say, I love what you did. What did I do to deserve this awesomeness? You know, the book could care less what I did or what I made it look like. So the book is not going to tell me anything. The client is. So after branding and promoting the author, the book follows. So my job is to make sure that the client looks spectacular. You walk into one of my clients' book launch and you see a huge poster of the cover of his book, you're going to praise the author, right? You know, I have never met anyone that stood in front of a poster of a book cover and told it, not bad, you did good. No, it doesn't happen that way. You see a poster of a book cover, you're going to praise the author. Unless it's a Maxim centerfold or an NFL cheerleader or something, then you're talking to the poster. But they praise the author about the book, and that is why my concern is with the author and his happiness, not the book. He is paying me to make him look good. The book is what I like to call the bonus surprise.
And that is very true. And this is why, and we get back to what we said at the top of the show, this is why it is so important to have a good graphic designer in your wheelhouse when you are working on the product, because it doesn't matter what's between the front and back cover. If people don't see the cover, if it doesn't stand out from the herd, they're just going to pass right over it.
Exactly. And they're going to look over it. And when you have somebody that is not qualified, and they're just fighting words, but I'm going to use them on tonight's show. When you have somebody that's doing your cover or even the inside of your book does not have a clue about what they're doing, you are setting yourself up for failure big time. It screams it. It literally tears its clothes off and says, I am self-publishing. I don't know what I'm doing.
You're so right.
And you can see that. And you know, I'm not going to lie, Yvonne. When I first met David back in 2005, I did not know exactly what I did or what I was doing. But David gave me a chance. David gave me a chance to work with him and to make myself productive. I'm still going to school at the Los Angeles Film School. And in graphic design, I'll be graduating from 2019. But I have learned so much since 2005, and I can spot when there's something wrong. I can spot when something's right. I maybe we need to add a little bit more color, maybe a little transparency. The list goes on. If you're looking to make money out of self-publishing, get off the radio show now, okay? I'm telling you right now, you will not make millions through self-publishing unless you are determined to do whatever you have to do to work hard and make it happen.
And that
and
is
I'm
very true.
And I'm going to show you, and I'm going to show you tonight how you can make your book a success. And a lot of authors don't know this, but there are some little details that you can tweak in your publishing, and your graphic designer is going to do that, by the way, that will make your book a success. The self-published book is basically a guinea pig, and you have to try your product in the fire until you find something that works. You have to tweak this and tweak that until something is actually going on. The book has to be readable. The cover has to stand out. It has to flow. The characters have to be likable. There has to be a plot that's somewhat believable. And the coverage is good. The description is good. You know, I mean, like the book I published for David called Little Gods. And this was my first book, ladies and gentlemen. This was my first book with David back in 2005. And I would probably, you know, just starting out, trying to do my best, trying to look like a, you know, I was basically a wannabe graphic designer. But Little Gods and this book received an honorable mention in 2009 at the Beach Book Festival. And this book was huge. It was a big deal. It's not as huge as my latest project with David, which was Babes and Bastards, which involved a photo shoot and a live model. But the point is, someone saw something unique that book to give it an honorable mention. And that is what a graphic designer will do.
And still on that subject, and to reiterate, that Babes and Bastards required you to find a love model and a photographic shoot. So in your wheelhouse, you also are a photographer, correct?
That is right. That's very true.
And when you are taking the photographs for these book covers to design them, do you see the story as you're taking the photographs?
I am. And as a matter of fact, when I'm done with the pictures, I'll send them back to David, and he'll look at all the pictures, and he's like, wow, I love these, and these are the top 50, and these are the top 10, and these are the top 5. And so I just kept all that and just went to the top 5. And that became the thing, you know, the picture. I love doing photos for covers. I love doing photos because I want it to be original. We have a question here from Lisa. She says, can I use pictures on Google for my covers, and can I get in trouble for using them? Okay. You don't use pictures from Google to put on your book cover. That is someone else's copyright. That's someone else's work. And if somebody has not made it what is called non-royalty photos, you can get penalized if the author or the artist of this picture finds you. However, if you need a picture for your cover, okay, there are two ways to go about it. One is to take the picture yourself, which is what I usually do, or hire a photographer, get a nice-looking model, get the picture, run it through Photoshop, run it through whatever you got to do, Lightroom, get the preset, get the effects, make it look good, and then go from there. Or you can go to what is called non-royalty pictures or stock photos. You can get them at iStock. If you have Adobe Creative Suite, you can use what is called Adobe stock photos, and that's like, I believe it's like $19.99 a month, which I pay for. A lot of my pictures come from Adobe Stock. But you don't want to take, or you can go to like a Creative Commons on site, you know, where there's free pictures that you can use. I use a lot of free videos for some of the trailers I do. But you do not want to grab any pictures off of Google. The other reason for that is because people will have seen that picture and they're going to know that's a self-published book right off the bat. That is a self-published book. And so you want to make sure that you get a picture that is not recognizable. You can also go to www.10i.com, upload the picture you have, and see how many times it's been used throughout the whole wide world web. It will tell you how many times that picture has been used. And so that's 10i.com. Also, if you do a picture or you use a photo or a non-royalty photo, inside the copyright page, make sure that you give credit to the photographer. That is very important.
That is extremely important, because what people don't realize is that is that photographer's product, just like our books are our product. And ladies and gentlemen, when you go to a pirated site and download free books, and I'm just going to throw this in here since we're talking about it. When you go to a pirated site and you download books that they have put up on there, or books, and there are several of my books that are on pirated sites, we can't get them down. But what you're doing is you're hurting me, the author of the book. You're dipping into my pocketbook. It's basically theft. And what happens is we get paid nothing for those pirated books. And while I don't wish to deny anyone the opportunity to read, that's why we have public libraries, that's how I make my living, is on my books. And when I don't get paid royalties, slim that they are, I mean, it's pennies on the dollar, ladies and gentlemen, that we get paid for our books. And we put in a lot of blood, sweat, tears, time, ripped up pages, elimination of chapters, cussing at the voices in our head. And it's like a baby that we've watched to grow up and sent out into the world. And when someone takes that book off of a pirated site, it hurts us emotionally, it hurts us financially, and it cheapens our work. So I'm all for you reading my work, and as every author is, but please buy it. Our books are not that expensive. We're half of what traditional publishing houses charge. Some of my work you can get for 99 cents. So please don't go to the pirated sites. Let's put them out of business. Go and pay that extra little bit and download or buy a paperback book, because you wouldn't want somebody taking something that belonged to you. Think of it as someone coming into your house and stealing something that's very precious to you. And that's how we feel when those pirated sites put our work up and don't charge folks for downloading it. Right, James?
That's right. And I want to correct you on something that you said. If you're an author and you have a book that is pirated and, oh, you get a special prize or pay to this site and you get this free download, David had that happen to him. And I can't remember from the top of my head, it's DM or DC something. And you basically have everything that is yours with this company. And when somebody puts up that book and it's being pirated, they go to them and say, take it down or else.
I must get that information, because several of my books are on pirated sites and I can't get them to take them down.
I would definitely get that information for you, because we had to do that with David, And then finally, we found a wonderful friend of ours that does this on a full-time basis for David. And he just tells these people, this is David Hook's work. You have 24 hours to get it off the website, or I will be suing you.
And see, there's another friend of mine, Stephanie Osborne. Her books have been published. Several of my author friends, they have found their work on pirated sites. And I know that it's the nature of this beast. I understand it. But it doesn't make it any less painful when I see all these numbers of downloaded pirated books as opposed to what should be on Amazon or on Barnes & Noble.
Mm-hmm. Well, there is something. And on the last show that David was on, he was talking about, you know, he made the statement, my publisher had just advised me that he's going to be moving some of my works, you know, into ebooks. And the reason why we haven't, for any of my clients, is because of the pirated books that were showing up online. However, there is, okay, so let's start from the beginning. iTunes, when you go to iTunes and you buy a song, it stays on iTunes. You can't play it anywhere else because it has a security thing on it that does not allow you to play it elsewhere. Well, when you publish with people like Nook Publishing or CreateSpace, it comes with a security that's the same thing, whereas if somebody took your book, they can't open it. And so that is being offered. So I forget what the name of it is, but it comes with it when you actually load your book as an e-book, and no one can pirate. And if they do, or even if they try, they can't open the book.
I will have to look into that one as well.
Yeah, and so that's why I'm moving David Butts over to another platform has that, and I'll give you all the information about it. It's so good to know that the people, the pressures on the distributorship that we care so much about have gone extra, you know, length and extra miles with technology to make sure that our work is taken care of and they're safe from hackers and people that want to duplicate the work and try to make money off of us.
That's true.
It's not right.
No, it is not right. It is not right at all, because unless someone has gone through the pain of birthing a book, they have no clue what it takes to make that book happen. It's not something that happens overnight.
Right.
And on that same vein, David, talk a little bit about the unprofessionalism that crops up and rears its ugly head in this industry, and there is quite a bit of it. So far, I've been lucky because I don't put up with it, but there is unprofessionalism in this industry.
There is. And let's go back to the start of the show. I was writing a book, and I got tracked off with Stephanie Meyer. You did it again, Stephanie. But I did it. You know, I was writing a book. I wanted to get my book out there. I had already, you know, played around with a few covers, and then I started hearing names of companies that were scams, and I started, you know, looking at websites like AbsoluteRight.com and the science fiction one, www.sfwa.org, where Victoria Strauss is on there. And Victoria, bless her heart, she's been a lifesaver and a guardian angel, because I'll call her up and I'm like, okay, is this one okay? Is this one okay? You know? And, you know, there's a lot of scammers. I'm not going to name companies, ladies and gentlemen. I don't want any legal problems with the companies, but I will say this much. there are companies out there that claim that they are traditional publishers when they're actually vanity. And you know what makes them, and it's not true, but you know what makes them a traditional publisher? They gave you a dollar in advance. And when you took that dollar, that made them a traditional publisher. Is it right? No. Okay. A lot of people want to be a part of traditional publishing. Traditional publishing has just about the same pros and cons as self-publishing does. You know, if you, a lot of people will say, oh, if only if I had a $25,000 advance, I would be so happy. My book would be out there. Okay, let me explain something. When you get that $25,000 check, and if you don't sell those books, you have to pay that back.
That is so true. And you only have a year to sell that advance money worth of books. And this is what people do not understand is when you sign a contract with one of the big six and they advance you that money, you have exactly 1 year to sell that amount of money in books. If you do not, you have to pay back what you didn't sell to the publisher. So if you get $25,000 in advance and you go out and you buy a new car, you buy a new house, and you don't sell that many books, you got to come up with whatever amount of dollars to pay that company back. And another thing that happens in traditional houses, James, is that you have to promise to put out at least 3 books a year. There's no way in hell I'm going to put out 3 books a year. I barely get out one because it takes me that long to get it like I want, or like the voices in my head want me to get it. But to just throw garbage in and garbage out, that is not fair to the reader.
That's right. And when you got a book, when I hear authors get excited, oh my God, Barnes and Noble just bought 10 of my books. Oh my gosh, I'm really going places. You know what? And I can't help but think you're going to stumble because I've never heard of you. You know, because when you get books in a Barnes and Noble, and you may think, you may go party and be happy about it that you got 10 books, but you're setting yourself up to fail because if you are not well known, if you're not doing the marketing, if you're not doing what you're supposed to do to make this book a success, all those 10, 20, 30, 40 books that Barnes & Noble was holding goes back, and it's on you. You have to pay
that
back.
You get back charged for it. So if you make $1,000 this month in royalties, the next month you're negative in the whole 150, that's because all those books that went to a box bookstore got shipped back. And let me tell you what they do, ladies and gentlemen. They order these books, right? They unbox them. They set them on a shelf for 30 days. Then they move them to the back of the store for another 30 days. At the end of 60 days, they box them back up and they send them back to the publishing house. The publishing house back charges the author for every returned book. So if you want to be in control of your destiny, you don't want that because it's inventory you don't need to worry about. Correct, James?
That is correct. I've got a question here from Carol Jensen. Carol, okay. She says, hi, James. I'm listening right now, and I just wanted to ask you, how do I get my books into bookstores?
Don't want them in bookstores.
Like brick and mortar, you know, like Barnes and Noble, you know. If self-publishing book can get into bookstores, it's not that hard. What that consists of is when you set up the book and you're setting up the pricing of the book, on the very end, it's going to ask you, do you want the books returned or destroyed? If you say that you want the books returned, the bookstores will not take your book. If you say, I want the book destroyed, That's no money on them, no money on you. You part your ways, it's all good. You can take your book into Barnes & Noble and say, hey, I've got my books. Here, two books. Can you put it on the shelf for 30 days, see how it does? If they go, and then we can put 10 more, you know, and I'll supply it, you know. And if it does really, really good, then you go ahead and buy a bundle, and I'll be sure. But make sure that if you do this, that you do not want the books returned. Because bookstores do not like books that they have to return. They want to sell them. They want them off the shelf. They want to make money. They're there to make money. They're only there about the money, not the book, not about you, not about what you wrote. They could care less. They want those books off the shelf so that they can make money. And if you say, I want those books returned, they're not going to look at you. You have to say, I want those books destroyed. And then they will work with you.
And the thing is, to the lady that asked you the question, I have never wanted my books in a brick and mortar store because the cons outweigh the pros. I get more sales online through Amazon and through Barnes and Noble than I would ever in a book and mortar brick and mortar store. And the reason is because unless you're a James Patterson or a Anne Rice or an Anne Rule, your book is not going to stand out as part of the herd. They're just going to be in there with all the rest of the herd. And unless somebody really knows who you are, they're not even going to go in the area where your book is. Now, what you can do is if someone wants to go into Barnes and Noble and go to the desk and say, I know you don't carry this book. However, would you order it for me? They will do that. They will look it up. They will place the order, and you can go into the bookstore and pick it up. Or your reader can go in the bookstore and pick it up. My suggestion is don't worry so much about it being in a brick-and-mortar store. Market your book as online or as straight sale from you to the reader so that you can sign the book and send it to them. It makes that more personal. Right, James?
That is. And we're almost running out of time. I want to throw a few more things real quickly. If you want a cover done, okay, you don't go to to an online book company that's going to charge you $10,000 to make your book, okay? You find a graphic designer, they're everywhere. Look for them on Facebook. I know that Yvonne knows someone. I know a couple. There is J.M. Rising Horse Creations. You can find Jennifer on Facebook. She does pre-made covers. There's also Booked and Covered. That's the letter N, not A-N-D, Booked and Covered. That's Lola Kyle. Tell her, let her know Jane sent you. They will help you. That's what they're there for, is to give you the covers that you need. When you have a graphic designer and you find one that's good for you and one that's good for your budget, you're going to go a long way.
Absolutely. And it, ladies and gentlemen, what we're saying is if you want to publish a book, that is what your heart's desire is. The book is not the brand. You are the brand. Two things. You have to brand yourself. I know it's difficult, but you have to brand yourself, like coming on this show. You have to make the internet your friend. That is how to be successful in the 21st century. You cannot come to you. You've got to go out and make it happen. Am I right, James?
That is very right. And one other point before we go, if you go to archerjocker.com, there'd be two people. Okay, and this is funny. And Yvonne and I were talking about this the other day on the phone. We were laughing about this whole thing, but it's really interesting. Matt Jockers and Jody Archer, and these two have a book out called The Bestseller Code. And what these two did was they presented an algorithm for detecting the sale potential of other books. They put in the 50 Shades of Grey, and it came out and said, hey, this is a great book. It's going to have great success. You're late. It already is, okay? It takes in contractions and not so many unnecessary words. And the bestsellers all have one thing in common. And when you write your book, keep this in mind. Human closeness and human connection. Love, separation, grief, whatever that. I mean, if you think about the movie, The Shack, that was about closeness with God, you know. And so people relate in different ways. You've got to be able to like the characters. They've got to be able to like the characters. So when you go on their website on archerjoker.com for $349 for a new manuscript, you can also do it for series and books you've already published, they will give you feedback to show you how to make your manuscript more marketable and let you know if it sells or not. And they will tell you how to get your book to where it needs to be so that it sells successfully online.
So tell the, and we are, you're right, we're going to run out of time. So before we do, tell the folks where you can be found so they can hook up with you.
Definitely. My last name is Karlson, K-A-R-L-S-O-N, Karlson Graphic Designs. So you can find me on Facebook, facebook.com/Karlson Graphic Designs. Send me a message. I've got a page on there called Karlson Graphic Designs, and let's see what we can do for you.
And ladies and gentlemen, I will bring him back, I promise, because we did not get through his 7 pages of notes. So I will bring him back. On January the 2nd, which is a Tuesday, at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, Eastern Standard Time, I will be holding a show. And the reason I'm doing it at 4 o'clock in the afternoon is because my author lives in the UK, and I don't want him calling in the middle of the night, which it would be if he was on at 8 o'clock. So join me at 4 o'clock in the afternoon on January the 2nd when I interview author Olive Newman. On January the 3rd at 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, Ellie Klass will be here. On January the 4th at 8 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, Linda Tillis. January the 5th at 8 o'clock, C.W. Thomas. And right behind that will be the show on Investigation Discovery with yours truly. And on Saturday night, January the 6th, Arthur Gary Starter will be with me again. So 2018 is proving to be a blast. I am already booked up through the middle of June, ladies and gentlemen. And I have more people that are coming in every day, so I expect higher year to be booked up. And, of course, there'll be changes as people fall out because for whatever reason they have a conflict. So I expect us to hit 500,000 listeners before the end of 2018. Don't ask me why, but it's there. We're going to do that. And I close the show, and I know James will come back because I thank him so much, James. Thank you so much for your expertise and your wisdom. And I know you'll come back. That is not even an issue. I don't even have to ask. So,
and I keep sending you offers, so you'll be finally booked.
Absolutely. And with the close of every show, there's some things that I say. Don't just feel special, be special. Because if you only feel special, you'll never be special. And if you want to achieve greatness, please stop asking permission, ladies and gentlemen. Just go out and do it. Because nobody's going to give you permission to be great. Think about that. Nobody's ever going to give you permission to be great. The difference between who you are and who you want to be is what you do. So if you want to be somebody different tomorrow, I suggest you change what you do today. Your smile is your logo. Your personality is your business card. How you leave others feeling after having had an experience with you, ladies and gentlemen, that is your trademark. People will forget your name. They will forget what you look like. They will forget what you're wearing. But they will never, ever, ever forget the way you make them feel. And I hope that all of my and my listeners feel wonderful when they leave this show. I have them tell me all the time, Yvonne, when can I come back on? I had so much fun. And that makes my day because I never want to ever feel like I have slighted a guest or a listener or a potential guest because each of you are important to me. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, my guest, graphic designer James Karlson, and I, your host, Yvonne Mason, here on Off the Chain. We want to thank you all so very much for 2017. Let's look for an even greater 2018, and let's spread the word. I will see you again on Tuesday afternoon at 4 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Until then, I say good night.
Good night, everybody.
So we're off the air now, James, and you know what I will do? When this goes into archives, I'll put it on the page, and then I'll tag you in it, and you're going to take this and run with it and use it to promote your business. Then tomorrow, I'll put up the 5 podcasts, the SoundCloud, Mixcloud, Podcast.com, Spreaker, and Podcast Garden, and send the links up on my page and tag you in it so that you can take those and run with it as well.
Sounds good. Have you been seeing how much marketing I've been doing on the show tonight?
I have. You've done an excellent job. I am so proud of you.
I my whole Facebook is just on the show.
I know. What an amazing thing. And next year, you are coming back. You will become a regular because people need to hear this, especially people that are just starting out that have this desire. And this just doesn't go to the publishing world. This isn't anything we do. You are a brand, and you have to have the tools to brand yourself, to market your product, whether it's a song, whether it's a painting, whether it's a business.
Oh, exactly. Fashion,
so
whatever it is.
Yeah. So your graphic design work is not limited to the publishing industry.
Mm-hmm.
So we will discuss that when I bring you back.
Definitely. Sounds good. And all you got to do is just let me know, and I will be here.
Okay. I might even bring you on if I have an open mic night, and we'll just chit-chat about a lot of things like we did before.
Oh, and if I'm not online, you just call me and say, Jane, call me.
I will do that. All right, my darling. Thank you again for a wonderful, fast show. I mean, it flew by, literally.
Not a problem. Not a problem, Mama. I'm always here for you.
Have a very good new year, my dear.
You too.
And I will be talking to you.
Sounds good. And I will talk with you later on in the week. If I have any more offers or whatever, You know the routine. We'll just go with that.
I do. You just send me a whole handful of them.
All right. Love you. Love you, Yvonne.
Love you too, honey. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.
All right, bye-bye.
Get a whole lot of fun out of every gallon with the highly efficient Fiat 500X. And right now at your local Fiat dealer, get $4,500 total cash allowance on the 2017 Fiat 500X Lounge. It's made to get the good times rolling with an EPA estimated 30 highway MPG and ready to keep them going with a Beats Audio premium sound system. Visit FiatUSA.com and your local Fiat dealer for great offers on the Fiat 500X. Available feature, residency restrictions apply. Take retail delivery from dealer stock by 1/2/18. Get a whole lot of fun out of every gallon with the highly efficient Fiat 500X. And right now at your local Fiat dealer, get $4,500 total cash allowance on the 2017 Fiat 500X Lounge. It's made to get the good times rolling with an EPA estimated 30 highway MPG and ready to keep them going with a Beats Audio premium sound system. Visit FiatUSA.com and your local Fiat dealer for great offers on the Fiat 500X. Available feature, residency restrictions apply. Take retail delivery from dealer stock by 1/2/18.